Hello IP students, today our topic is Python Pandas data frame, and this is Python Pandas data frame part 11. In this lecture we are going to discuss about histogram, how we can create a histogram in Python Pandas. So before starting Python Pandas histogram, let us look some important terminology regarding histogram. To understand the term histogram, first of all you should know about bar graphs. So what is bar graph? A bar graph is a graphical display of data using bars of different heights. So in bar graph there are basically different bars of different heights, and using bar graphs we can create a bar of data like movies. There is a small example here in which there is a table which reflects the favorite type of movies. There are basically five categories in movies. These are comedy, action, romance, drama, and sci-fi. So movies belongs to comedy category of 4, and action category is 5, romance is 6, drama is 1, and sci-fi is 4. So these are the basically different categories belonging to different types of movies. Now if you want to create a bar graph using this table, it can be reflected in this manner represented in your screen. So there are different bars representing different types of category of movies, and these are comedy, action, romance, drama, sci-fi, and represented bar graph is represented in x-axis and in y-axis. Y-axis represent number of pupils, and x-axis represent type of movies. So bar length of bar represent basically what type of movie like by how many number of people. So this is a basically reflection of a bar chart when we use a data, raw data. And here raw data is basically types of movies, and if you want to know that which type of movies liked by how many numbers of people, then we can easily represent it using bar graph. So this is a bar graph, and it is a good way to show relative size, and we can see which type of movie are most liked and which are least liked at a glance. So this is the advantage of a bar graph, and we can use bar graph to show the relative size of many things, such as what type of can people have, how many customer of a shop has on a different days, and so on. So basically this is the use of bar graph. So now I think you all of know have a good idea about bar graph. Let us begin another topic, which is our main topic, and that is a histogram. So what is histogram? A histogram is a graphical display of data using bars of different heights. So and how it can be different from a bar chart? Actually both looks like same, but there is a little bit different between histogram and a bar chart. Histogram actually represent continuous set of data. In bar chart there may be a gap between different bars, but in histogram it is not so. There is no gap between different bars here. So that is the basic difference between bar graph and a histogram. And here there is an example in which histogram is represent, and it is, and here written here a line is written as it is similar to bar chart, but a histogram group number into ranges. So basically histogram groups numbers into different ranges, or we can say the different categories or different class intervals, and sometimes it is called as bins. So the height of each bar shows how many falls into each range. So we can see that it also represents frequency also, and you decide what range to use. So that is all about histogram. Histogram and bar graph, there is a basic difference between these two, as I told you earlier, but it is a very important point. So we can both create bar graph and histogram, but using Python pandas, we can only create histogram. For using other charts such as part chart, bar chart, scatter chart, if you want to create these type of charts, then there is another library called matplotlib.pyplot. So using this library function, you can create, using this library there are many functions which are useful to create bar chart, scattered chart, even histogram. You can also create histogram using matplotlib. So there are basically two functions to create a histogram, and one using Python pandas and second one using matplotlib library. So both can be used to create a histogram. Here our main focus is to create a histogram using Python pandas. So now let us take another example. This is an example of height of an orange tree. So you may sure that the height of every tree is occurs in centimeter, and the height is vary from 100 centimeter to 340 centimeters. There is another example which shows the use of histogram and how can we create histogram. Suppose there are heights of orange trees and different height, and these height are measured in centimeters, and height range start from 100 to 340 centimeter, and if you want to put the result into groups of 50 centimeters, so we can take here range as 50 centimeter. So the 100 to just below 150 centimeter range, and the 150 to just below 2 centimeter range, etc. This is the meaning of this. So for a tree is 260 centimeter tall is added to the 250 and 300 range, because 260 lies between 250 and 300 meter range. So here there are a few things. First of all, this is all about the tree's height, and second thing is we can measure the height of a tree in terms of centimeters, and here we can group them into a size of 50 centimeters. So suppose if there is a group or bin or class interval 250 to 300, it means that 260 261, these all values lie between these intervals. Next, so using histogram we can represent this as the given on a screen, and this is a result. This is a tree height. So and vertical axis, it means y axis represents number of trees lies in this category, and horizontal line, this means x axis represent class intervals. So as I told you that class interval is of 50 centimeter, that's why there is a class interval of 100 to 150, and then after 150 to 200, and then 250 to 300, and 300 to 350. These are the class intervals. Remember one point, that in a histogram we cannot use a blank value between two or more bars, because in histogram is continuous. But if in a particular range there is no value, then this will reflect as an empty bar, or this will reflect as an empty. But it doesn't mean that it is not a histogram. It is even a histogram, but we can say that between the for a particular class range or interval there is no value at all. So this is another important point, and we can say that when we see the horizontal line, it is continuous. That means 100, 150, 150 to 200, 200, 250. It doesn't make like this 100 to 149, then 150 to 199, then 200. So it is continuous. 150, 100 to 150, 200 to 250, 300 to 350, etc. Next is Python, pandas. So again, there is a difference between bar chart and histogram. We can easily see that there is a pictorial representation which shows the difference between bar graph and histogram. We can easily see that there is no gap in histogram while there is a gap in bar graph. So bar graph, there is always gap between bars, and there is no gap in histogram between different bars. So that is the basic difference between a bar graph and a histogram. Both look like the same, but the only difference is that there is no gap in histogram while there is certain gap in bar graph. So, and as far as its purpose is concerned, histogram are used for continuous set of data. It means that data must be in a continuous, there is no gap between data. And it reflect, or it is useful when we want to create histogram using weight, height, time, etc. And using bar chart, we can create a bar chart using raw data such as country or favorite movies. So these are the types of data by which we can use, we can create bar graph or histogram. Next is frequency histogram. So what is frequency histogram? Frequency means how many number of time a certain value appears in a data set. It is the frequency. So in frequency histogram is a special graph that uses vertical columns to show frequencies. So in which vertical columns represent frequencies. So there is a small example here. There are some scores, and we can easily see that score are represented such as 1 1 2 2 2 2 2 3 3 3 3 4 4 5, in which we can easily see that 1 appears 2 times, 2 appears 5 times, 3 appears 4 times, 4 appears 2 times, and 5 appears only 1 time. So in this example, data appears more than 1 times. If data appears number of times, then it is called the frequency. For example, frequency of 2 is 5, frequency of 3 is 4, frequency of 4 is 2, and frequency of 5 is 1, because 5 is only one time here, 2, 4 appears here 2 times, 3 appears here 4 times, and 2 appears here 2 appears here 5 times only, and 1 appears 2 times, so frequency of 1 is 2. So this is a frequency histogram which represent frequency. And a frequency histogram is a special graph that uses vertical columns to show frequency. So in frequency histogram, vertical columns represent frequencies. Now there is another example using which another histogram can be created. And here bin means the class interval. Class interval is 20, 30, 30, 40. We can easily see that it is continuous data. 40, 50, 50, 60, 60, 70, 70, 80, 80, 90, and 90 to 100. And frequency related to these are 2, 4, 4, 5, 3, 1, 0, 1. And score included in bin. There are certain score. Actually, there are 20 scores. And belong to this category, belong to category 20, 30. We can easily see that 28 and 40 lies in this category, and 30 to 40 there are only four values: 37, 38, 35, and 38 again. 38 appears two times. In range 40 to 50 there are four values: 44, 46, 45, and 48. And 50 to 60 there are again four values. These are 53, 50. 3, 51, 58, and 57, 53 appears two times here. And 60 to 70, 69, 66, 62, 70 to 80, 74, 80 to 90, there is no value. 80 to 90, and 90 to 100 is only single value 92. So there are basically 20 values, and here we take, and here the class interval is of 10, bin is 10, and there are different now, and there are different frequency regarding each bin. So when we say that interval is 20 to 30 and there are two values, so we can say that for this range of interval the frequency is 2, because two values lies in this category. So this is the frequency. And for 30 to 40 there are, since four values lies in this category, so we can say that there are four values or frequency is 4. For 40 to 50 there are again four values, so we can say that frequency is 4. And for 50 to 60 there are five values, so frequency is 5. For 60 to 70 there are three values, so frequency is 3. For 70 to 80 there is only single value, that's why frequency is 1. For 80 to 90 there is not even a single value, that's why frequency we can say that is 0. And 90 to 100 there is a frequency 1. So frequency means for a range, how many numbers lies within the range is also a frequency. And also if particular, for a particular data set we can say that how many number of times a particular data appears, and for data a number of times it will appear is called the frequency of particular type of data. But since here we can take the frequency of intervals, so whatever be the value lies between these data set or bins or class interval, it is called the frequency of that data set. Now here one thing should be noticed, that unlike a bar chart there is no gaps between the bars and reflecting no frequencies. There is some spelling mistakes here. Bar BAR and frequency FREQUENCIES. So histogram represent a continuous data sets, as such there are no gaps in the data. So overall we can easily see that as far as difference is concerned between bar chart and histogram, the difference is that in bar chart there is no gap of data, in histogram there is. In bar chart there may be a gap of data, but in histogram there is no data gap, and histogram represent continuous set of data. Now as far as this now the syntax is concerned, syntax is first of all write the name of data frame, and then after put dot sign, and then after hist, and now there are some parameters. These are columns, by, grid and bins. So these are the columns, and default values are none, true and tens. So these are the default values, and this is a syntax of creating data frame using Python pandas. So columns represent string or sequence. By is optional, so it's when it passed then used to form histogram. Grid is basically boolean value, means we can represent its value in terms of true and false, and by default it is true. To show access grid lines, and bins again is an integer or sequence, and default is 10. If we don't mention bin, then default is 10. So bins are the number that represent the interval into which you want to group the source data. And as I told you earlier, that bins is basically the class interval, and if you don't mention the bins then by default it is 10. And here one line should be noticed, that a histogram display numerical data by grouping data into bins of equal width. So bins must be of equal width, not they are not vary, all bins are of equal width. And each bin is plotted as a bar hole, right, height corresponding to how many data points are in that space. So overall we can say that there are four values or parameters. There are four parameters basically that can be passed in histogram. These are columns, by, grid and bins. And using Python pandas, we want to create a histogram. Then just write histogram and then after dot hist function. So the name of the function which can create histogram in Python pandas is HIST. So HIST is the name of function which, by which we can create histogram. And that is the important question. That is a very important question for your examination. In 1 marks, it is easily asked that which function create histogram in Python panda. So the answer is HIST, hist function is used to create histogram. Now there is a small example here which is used to create a histogram in Python pandas. And here we use here two basic library, Python pandas and matplotlib. As I told you earlier that using matplotlib we can create histogram. So there is a function, this is a part of matplotlib by which we can create histogram. But here we don't create we don't want to create histogram using matplotlib. Still there is a matplotlib.pyplot library, because there is a function, show function. After create a histogram, if you want to show its representation, a pictorial representation, then there is a function named show function, SHOW, show function. And using this function we can easily see the graph or the chart in our screens. So that's why we use here matplotlib.pyplot. And histogram is created here using Python pandas library. So first two lines suggest that there are two libraries, and name of libraries are pandas and matplotlib.pyplot. The alternative name for pandas is PD, and alternative name for matplotlib.pyplot is PLT. So whenever we want to use these libraries, just write PLT and PD in place of matplotlib.pyplot and for pandas, after that dot sign and after that name of function. So first of all, what we want to create, we want to create here a simple or dictionary, simple or data frame. And data frame is created using a dictionary. And the name of data frame is df. So we write df and assign a value pd.dataframe, and there is a dictionary pass as a parameter in data frame. And there are two index value, length and width, and value regarding to these are 1.5, 0.5, 1.2, 0.9 and 3, and for width are 0.7, 0.2, 0.15, 0.2 and 1.11. And also there is an index, and this index suggests that these are the name of animals, and total number of index are 5 and total number of values are also 5. So now the role of hist function begins. So we take a variable name HIST, and function name is also HIST, but HIST, when we write a symbol of parenthesis, then it is a function. And we can take HIST as a variable name also. So there is an assignment of a value df.hist and bins is equal to 3. So number of intervals here we take is equal to 3. That's why bins is equal to 3. And now if you want to show the output, so just write plt.show. plt is a alternative name of matplotlib.pyplot library. Matplotlib.pyplot is chapter 3rd, and after this matplotlib and pyplot, matplotlib.pyplot library will be discussed. But here we use here to show the final answer, and it basically represent the graph or bar chart. That's why we use matplotlib.pyplot here, only because of just show the final answer or pictorial representation of our graph, which we and the graph is created using here is using hist function. So hist is equal to df dot hist means is equal to 3. So there are three values. Now let us check. So two graph are there, and why there are two graphs because there are two values passed within a data frame, one for length and one for width. That's why there are two graphs, and we can easily see that there are two intervals also. Three intervals, 1, 2, and 3, and it is because we pass bins is equal to 3, and that is similar for second case. And this is represented for length, and this is represent, and this graph is for width, and this graph is for length. So there are two graphs, one for length and one for width, and there is a color of blue. So by default we can say that blue color is there. We don't pass any color, then default color of histogram is blue. So this is another important question which will be asked, that what is the default color of histogram. Default color of histogram is blue, and that is the y-axis, or represent frequencies of data. So this is for length and breadth. Now let us take another example. This is second program, and in this program there is a little bit change here. Rest of the program is same as that of previous one, but here we take two values, bins is equal to 5 and colors is equal to red. So here we change the class interval as well as color. So we take color here is equal to red. If you want to take a color, then write color as a parameter. Remember that when we discuss the syntax of any function regarding to Python, pandas, data frame, then only the essential parameters will be discussed there, and it doesn't mean that something that is important, something that is useful, or something that may be useful for a certain function will be discussed. So not all types of parameters are discussed, but only the important or the essential, or that may be asked in examination, or that may be asked in examination or important for examinations, are only discussed here. So color is color is one of the parameter passed within hist function, but it is not important. But here if we want to select or choose the color, then we can use it, and that's why color is equal to red. Remember that we used only four parameters, but here color is used here. So bins is equal to 5 and color is equal to red. So what happens, let us take its exit. So this is the final answer. We can see that there are 5 intervals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there is a gap also. It doesn't mean that this is a bar chart. It is, even there is a gap, it is a histogram. And why it is a histogram? Because there is no value lies between these range or intervals. That's why these are represented as a blank. So blank doesn't mean that empty. Blank doesn't mean that it is a bar chart. It is even a histogram if represented by a blank value. But it means here that there is no value lying in this interval. For first one, there is no value lying in this intervals. So this is length and width again. So now we can conclude the lecture. Histogram is basically represent the continuous set of data, and the difference between bar chart and histogram is that bar chart does not represent continuous set of data. There may be a gap between different bars, but there is no gap in histogram. And in Python pandas data frame, to create histogram, there is a function named hist functions, and using hist function we can easily create hist using hist function we can easily create histogram and even frequency histogram. So yeah, so these, and here we discuss two examples of programs to create histogram. Now it is end of the video. I hope you like this.